Right, today we are going to talk about eye movements, right? The mechanisms of eye movements. And first of all, I will just give a very brief introduction about the types of eye movements. And after that, today we will talk in detail about the horizontal conjugate eye movements. But before we really go for the main topic, I will talk about what are the important types of eye movements, right? Types of eye movements. Basically, there are so many ways to classify the eye movements. One of the simple ways that we classify them into two types. Number one is conjugate movement, conjugate eye movements, or number two, vergence movements. Now, what are the conjugate eye movement? Let me tell you that. Look here, right? Let's suppose right now I'm focusing on, I'm focusing on this object, right? But if this object is shifted to right side, you see this eye will move outward and other eye will move inward. But both of them, if they have to keep the focus on that object, then both eye should move in a conjugate fashion. Conjugate fashion means they should move in such a way that their axis, the visual axis, should remain parallel and both should move what? Same degree. They should move in the same degree, and both of them as object from the right, I moved it to the left, right? So from the center, I moved it to the right. Then right eye will move rightward and left eye will also move rightward. Actually, both eyes moved rightward, right, to keep the focus. Is that right? But let's suppose if I put an object here, now my both eyes are looking there. But actually, what happened? Again, both eyeballs moved in a conjugate fashion. Both eyeballs move in the same parallel axis. And if they are focusing here, right, then in this case, left eye should move outward and right eye should move inward. So what really happens? Conjugate movement means that when we say there's conjugate movement of the eyes, it means that two eyeballs, they move in a parallel axis. This is rightward horizontal movement, and this is neutral position, or we can say this is primary position of the eyeballs. This is conjugate movement in horizontal plane to the leftward. So in the horizontal plane, eyes can move right gaze, right lateral gaze, and they can be left lateral gaze. This is one type of movement, conjugate. Now, conjugate movement can be of two types. Conjugate movement can be in the what? Horizontal axis, or they can be in the vertical axis. When you, for example, if I'm looking at the roof, then of course both eyes should move upward. It shouldn't happen that one eye is going up, another is going down. Why? Because actually within the eye, in the retina, the point which is most sensitive, right, for image building, that is fovea, right? Now, fovea centralis, actually, when we focus an object, we are putting the image of that object exactly on the fovea. Is that right? So, when if I want to look at an object which is up, then both eyeballs should move upward. And if I bring the object down, then both eyeballs should look down. So, it means that conjugate movements of the eyeballs are not only in horizontal plane, conjugate movements are also in vertical plane. This is up gaze and this is down gaze, and this is right lateral gaze, and here it is left lateral gaze. Is that right? So now you understand what is conjugate movement. Again, I will repeat, conjugate movement of the eyeballs is those movements of the eyeballs in which both eyeballs move with what fashion? In the same degree, in a direction, to keep the focus on an object, or to bring the focus of an object to the fovea of the both eyes. Is that right? And this movement can be horizontal conjugate movements, or they can be vertical conjugate movement. Is that right? What does it mean? There must be a very powerful and very precise neural mechanisms involved. Otherwise, what will happen? Your eye, right eye may be moving, looking to the right side, and left eye may be looking on upside. And of course, then you will develop different images, and you will develop diplopia. Diplopia means that visual field that appears as double image. Is that right? But for binocular vision, the vision which you develop with both eyes, right? To develop the binocular vision, whenever there is eye movement, it should be conjugate. Is that right? Except in versions which I will tell later. So we can say that conjugate movements can be, yes, in two planes, horizontal conjugate movement, horizontal conjugate eye movements, and there can be, yes, vertical conjugate eye movements. Is that right? I will explain versions later. Now, if we really focus on horizontal conjugate eye movement, right, which is the main topic of interest today, that horizontal conjugate eye movements, right? So it means that we are only talking about that how eyeballs move in the right gaze or move left gaze. Now, there are different types of horizontal conjugate eye movement. Let me explain. Let's suppose here I am holding two objects in my hand, right? Of course, this is on the right side, this is on the right side, and this is on the left side. Now, right now I am looking straight. When I am looking straight, what does it mean? That eyes are in the neutral position, or they are in the primary position, right? And now, if I shift my gaze to this object, I will do like that. So what kind of movement is this? Right conjugate movement. And you see, both eyes have moved, and this eye is moving outward. So here the lateral rectus should be working, and this eye has moved inward. So which rectus should be working here? Medial rectus. So what is happening? That when this conjugate movement, for example, in this movement, I'm focusing here, when I'm moving the eye to the rightward, then right eye lateral rectus should fire, and left eye medial rectus should fire. But if I make a conjugate movement to the, what is this?
Left
side. Now this one, I'm making conjugate movement of the eyes to the left side. And if they are left side, then left eye lateral rectus should contract, and right eye medial rectus should contract. So what we learn from this, that when there is horizontal movements of the eyeballs, is that right? When there is conjugate movement of eyeballs in the horizontal plane, when there is conjugate movement of the eyeballs in the horizontal plane, phase or plane, then if right one eye lateral rectus is contracting, then other eye medial rectus should contract. And or if this side, if lateral rectus is contracting, then here medial rectus. Is that right? Rapidly tell me, in this movement which muscles are involved? Lateral rectus of right, and medial rectus of left eye. And if this movement, lateral rectus of left eye and medial rectus of right. So it means, you know that lateral rectus is supplied by the sixth cranial nerve, and medial rectus is supplied by the oculomotor nerve, or third cranial nerve. It means that if I'm looking at this side, my sixth cranial nerve is firing lateral rectus, right? If my conjugate right gaze is there, which nerve is firing from pons? Sixth cranial nerve, which supplies the lateral rectus. And which other nerve is firing? Third cranial nerve, which innervate medial rectus. If sixth nerve nucleus, it means sixth nerve nucleus and third nerve nucleus should fire almost simultaneously with the same degree, right? In the same way, when we look here, there are two, three ways to tell this situation. One way is to tell that my eyeballs are leftward, left gaze. Other way is, in this situation, my left eye lateral rectus is working and right eye medial rectus is working. Another way, that on left side, sixth cranial nerve is firing, or sixth cranial nerve nucleus abducens is firing, and in the right eye, because medial rectus is contracting, so which nerve is? Oculomotor nerve with this oculomotor nucleus, and that subnucleus of the oculomotor which supplies the medial rectus, that is firing. So it means when there is a horizontal conjugate movement, if one eye is lateral rectus firing, other is medial rectus firing, one eye is sixth cranial nerve firing, other is third cranial nerve firing, one is sixth abducens nucleus firing, and other side there should be oculomotor nucleus should be firing, and because they fire same time, it means they must be interconnected, they must be able to talk to each other, they must be able to communicate. That when I look at this side, if sixth nerve nucleus is firing, it must be able to communicate with the third nerve and bring this eye medially inward, right? And if I'm looking here, then sixth cranial nerve nucleus should fire from the left side, but at the same time it should be able to communicate with oculomotor nerve nucleus on the right side. So there must be intertalk between the nuclei as well. Now this is a basic concept of conjugate movement. Now what are the types of different horizontal conjugate movements? Types of conjugate movement, let me explain it simply. Let's suppose I'm primarily looking at this object, right? And then I decide to look at red marker. So I will do a rapid movement here. Is that right? I jerk rapidly to the right side. Then I decided to look at the black marker. It went rapidly. So this rapid movement of the eyeball, you see, I'm alternating my focus from red marker to black marker. You look at the eye movements. Now these eye movements are slow, rapid. These are rapid eye movements. These are horizontal conjugate movement and they're rapid type. And purpose of this movement is, for example, first if I was focusing on the red marker, it means image of the red marker was falling on the fovea of both eyes. But I decided voluntarily to look at the black marker, it means black marker became the object of my interest. Then I need to move the eyeballs in such a fashion that now image of the black marker should fall on the fovea of my both eyes. Is that right? Now this rapid movement in which from one fixation point, when your eyes are fixated on one point or one object of interest and you refixate it to another object, eyes move a rapid movement in horizontal plane. In this case, this type of movements are called sakadic movement. What we call them?
Sakadic
movement or sakads. Sakads. So what are sakads? I'm showing you the voluntary sakads, right? Again, listen, these are sakadic movement. Now I'm going to show where the rapid eye movement, right, from one point of interest, eyes unlock from here, from this fixation point, and then move rapidly and fixate on, yes, new object of interest. So this movement, now I will repeatedly move you my eyeballs, right, my VN, axis of VN, from one object to the other, and eyes will make rapid movement, and you have to tell me what kind of movements are this. Say it loudly. Of course, when they are rapid, voluntary, jerky, you can say movement, but they are not jerk, they are jerky. Look, right? What are these movements? Say card. Say it loudly. So what are these movements going on?
Say-card.
Which say card? Vertical or horizontal?
Say-card.
Yes. Again, what movements are these?
Horizontal
saccades. What are these movements? Horizontal
saccades.
So horizontal conjugate movement are saccadic movement. Saccadic movements are basically rapid shift in the eyeballs. Rapid shift in the axis of eyeballs in a conjugate fashion to unlock from one point of interest to focus another point of interest. For example, you are happily sitting here and you see there is an old woman standing there. You are young boys, I know what's going on in your mind. So there's an old woman standing there, you are just looking how old she is, and she look like a very decent, and she looks like a very, you can say, elegant woman. And suddenly in your field of vision, a young girl appear there, and you will have a rapid saccadic movement. Is that right? It may be voluntary or sometimes even faster. It's a very rapid shift in the, and that is now you see, oh, she is young, she is sexy, she is, maybe you feel provocative, she may not be provocative but or inviting, but you may imagine like that, whatever. But the thing is that this was a rapid shift from older woman to younger woman, right? What kind of this movement was?
Saccadic
movement or saccade, right? So you understand what is saccade?
Yes.
right? Or just imagine you are walking on the road and talking to your wife, right? And suddenly a very beautiful smart girl appear there, and you have which kind of movement? Saccadic. And after that, what kind of wife will bring the movement? You will suffer, if not physically, at least emotionally. There will be immediate punishment or little delayed, right? But it will be there, because your wife will also have saccadic movement and see where you have refocused suddenly. So these are, what are saccadic movements? They are rapid shift in the axis of the eyeballs in a conjugate fashion from one object of interest to refocus on another or focus on another object of interest, right? These are horizontal saccadic movement. Now, there's another type of horizontal movement. Let me tell you that, let's suppose I'm focusing on this object, and if this object is gradually moving, okay, I'm focusing on this. Let me tell you more clearly, because they always confuse me. I want you to be clear about it. I'm focusing here, right? Okay, let me make it this. This is the older woman, and this is the younger woman. You are looking at her and appreciating her elegance, right? And suddenly someone come very, what is this movement? From here, saccadic. And then she starts moving towards the older woman. Now my eyes are still moving. These are called, your eyes are pursuing the younger girl movement. What is this called? Smooth pursuit movement. What is this? Smooth pursuit movement. Again, for example, there is an older woman standing there. You are focusing to her and appreciating her elegance. But suddenly, a younger girl, very beautiful girl, very interesting girl, appear in your field of vision, not field of interest. But soon she may become in the field of interest. So from here, a jump. What is this? Saccadic move. But the younger woman is walking towards the older woman. So what will happen? Your eyes will track her. The smooth tracking movement, if no one is there to interrupt you harshly. So the smooth what? Tracking movement or smooth pursuing movement. This was also horizontal movement, and this was also what? Horizontal, smooth and pursuing. So we call it what kind of movement? They were saccade, and after that, this movement is smooth pursuit move, eye movements, right? Saccades were rapid jerky movement, rapid ballistic movement, or fast rapid conjugate movement. These are horizontal saccades. There are vertical saccades also. In the same way, they are smooth tracking movement. When an object is mobile and you keep focus on the mobile object and eyeballs keep on tracking that and move in a conjugate fashion, right? That is smooth pursuit movement, a smooth tracking movement. Why I'm trying to tell the difference in them? Actually, pathways, neural pathways which control the saccadic movement and neural pathways which control the smooth pursuit movements, they are different, right? And then there is another movement. Let's suppose